A very good morning to all dignitaries, delegates, chief guests, and participants. With great joy and immense exultation, I, on behalf of the IIITDM community, wholeheartedly welcome everyone to the 5-day FTC program on machine learning algorithms for 5G mobile networks. I now invite Dr. M.D. Selvaraj Sir, coordinator at LFTP on ML 5G, and also Dean Sponsored Research and Industrial Consultancy, IIITDM, to welcome the gathering.
Thank you, Kirtana. Honorable Director, distinguished Chief Guest, respected HOD, and my dear colleagues, dear participants, a very good morning to one and all. It gives me immense pleasure to welcome all of you to the inaugural ceremony of this morning, to the 5-day faculty development program on machine learning algorithms for 5G mobile networks. 5G is fifth generation mobile technology that brings three different things to the table: huge data rates, that's network speed, low latency, responsiveness, and more bandwidth, the ability to connect to lot more IoT devices. So more bandwidth it provides. But users will know it as one of the fastest, most robust technologies in the world as ever seen. That means quicker downloads, much lower lag, and a significant impact on how we live, work, and play. The connectivity benefits of 5G are expected to make businesses more efficient, give consumers access to more information faster than ever. Connected cars, smart communities, industrial IoT, immersive education, they all will rely on 5G networks only. Unlike 4G LTE, 5G operates based on a new mobile networking principle such as millimeter wave communication, NOMA, etc. Due to the rapid increase in the number of subscribers, there has been an increase in the multimedia traffic in the mobile base stations. The new 5G interface can further enhance to deliver a much higher degree of flexibility and scalability. This could provide more 5G access by expanding usage of the spectrum resources from sub 3 GHz used in 4G to 100 GHz and beyond in 5G. The 5G can operate both in lower bands, especially sub 6 GHz, especially 3 GHz to 6 GHz, that is what they are targeting, as well as millimeter wave, example 24 GHz up to 29.5 GHz. So that is another band they are planning, which is a higher band. And in US and other countries also, people considerably thinking about 60 GHz and provides a 2 GHz bandwidth per user. This is a huge bandwidth we are going to get. So therefore, the data rates are very high, which will bring extreme capacity, multi-gigabits throughput, and low latency. 5G is designed to not only deliver faster, better mobile broadband services compared to the 4G LTE, but also expand into the new service areas such as massive IoT. This is further enhanced by applying artificial intelligence such as machine learning algorithms to 5G mobile networks. Because of the big data from the IoT, there is a huge amount of data at the cloud. So therefore, there is a need to analyze those data efficiently and effectively. Therefore, we need to have these machine learning algorithms on place. So this FTP includes a number of advanced topics regarding the machine learning algorithms for 5G mobile networks. And this FTP has been designed to be practical with the lectures, examples, practice sessions to provide skills, encourage participation, and exchange information. The FTP talks are delivered by eminent speakers from IIT, NIT, IIIT, and industries. Totally 103 participants from 18 states have registered and participating in this FTP. The 5-day FTP consists of totally 15 sessions and each session of 2-hour duration. So that means one day we are having 6 hours of workshop. Please note that the attendance will be taken for every session and attendance of 80% per participants in the overall workshop 5 days is mandatory. Without that, there is no certificate etc. And by end of the 5-day FTP, a test will be conducted and participant scoring above 60% in the test will be awarded a certificate from the Atal AICT and with the institute logo. I warmly welcome you again to this FTP, and I hope that everyone would take the results of this program to develop many more new technological advances in 5G. So again, I welcome you all to the Shubhra ITDM family. So welcome you all, one and all. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I humbly invite Dr. Priyanka Kokil, ma'am, HOD, Department of ECE, Triple ITDM, to deliver the department address.
Thank you, Kirtana. A very good morning to our director, Professor Soumya Jullu, our chief guest, Dr. Sai Dheeraj Amuru, IIT Hyderabad, faculty colleagues, students, and importantly, all amazing participants who have registered for this program. It is my pleasure to welcome you all in Atal-sponsored virtual 5-day faculty development program on machine learning algorithms for 5G mobile networks, starting from today, 4th October till 8th of October. Role of machine learning and 5G in our lives today is no more a hidden secret. Today's world is surrounded by data, in fact, a huge chunk of data. Number of mobile subscribers are also increasing day by day. As per TRAI, the number of telephone subscribers in India increased to 120.9 crore at the end of July 21, a monthly growth of 0.57%. Therefore, 5G mobile networks need to handle a big data of subscribers. So therefore, in this very brief description, because I'm sure that you will be having a lot more details in the coming program, and in fact, sir has already informed so many things. So this program is definitely a demand or a need of this hour, that where we can see what is the role of machine learning in 5G networks. I'll not take too much time here. I'll give a brief description about the department. We are Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering at IITDM Kanchipuram, having 18 faculty members, 7 technical staff. The department offers BTech in Electronics and Communication Engineering and 2 MTech programs. In the first one is MTech in Electronics and Communication Engineering with specialization in communication systems, and the other is MTech in Electronics and Communication Engineering with specialization in microelectronics and VLSI systems. The department is majorly divided into 4 research groups. The first one is RF and communication, second is signal processing, third is VLSI, fourth is power and energy. So almost the department is involved in almost all types of research areas, and all the faculty members are involved actively in executing various projects obtained from Science and Engineering Research Board or National Board of Higher Mathematics, DRDO, DST, MIT, IIT Hyderabad under National Mission on Interdisciplinary Cyber Physical Systems, various industries such as Samsung, HBL, etc. I'm sure under the able coordinatorship of Dr. M.D. Selvaraj, the program is going to be a wonderful and extremely successful, and you all, the amazing participants, will have a great time and great learning in coming 5 days. Therefore, I welcome you all once again to the program and wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for your wonderful speech about our department. Faculty members regularly organize the FDP conference and workshop because of the motivation, guidance, and blessings of our director. On behalf of the entire IITDM community, I invite our respected director to deliver the inaugural address.
Yeah, good morning, everybody. First of all, I congratulate the Department of ECE for taking up this initiative of conducting Atal Faculty Development Program on machine learning for 5G mobile networks. But AICT has come up with a very wonderful activity under the umbrella of Atal Academy. So this Atal Academy is a very good initiative that has been used for conducting various faculty development programs to upgrade the knowledge, also to train the faculty in emerging thrust areas such as IoT, machine learning, AI, blockchain, robotics, renewable energy, augmented reality, virtual reality, etc. These activities are being conducted by various prominent organizations from our country, such as IITs, IIMs, NITs, IITs, IISc, ISI, JNU, DRDO, etc. And also some central universities by inviting leading experts from academia, industry, and research labs from within the country and abroad. So when I saw the title, Machine Learning Algorithms for 5G Mobile Networks, it is a purely application-oriented workshop. So you all know that 5G mobile networks is coming up in a big way. And now this FDP purpose is how effectively we can apply the machine learning algorithms is going to be a key role in 5G networks. 5G mobile networks are expected to be to provide ubiquitous, high data rate, and seamless connectivity to mobile subscribers. In recent times, machine learning techniques have created revolution in all the spheres of science and technology. Such an impact is possible as a result of advanced models, large data sets, and high computational powers of the machines. As the number of mobile subscribers increase year after year, the 5G mobile networks need to handle big data of the subscribers. Therefore, machine learning algorithms play a significant role in solving problems of 5G networks. I came to know that this FDP has planned to give an overview of how ML will impact the 5G mobile networks. So in this regard, actually, Ministry of Education, Government of India, has already initiated several activities. One of the first activity initiated by ministry is publishing of a white paper with the title Artificial Intelligence for All, which was a white paper published by Niti Aayog sometime in the year 2017-18, which provides overall understanding of various types of AI, machine learning, big data. These are all buzzwords today in the industry also. So therefore, we should provide exposure on how these algorithms are going to play in the specific applications pertaining to 5G networks. So in my opinion, this type of activity gives you a great exposure to all the faculty of IITM Kanchipuram and also the faculty of other engineering colleges. In addition to that, I would like to also highlight in a recent conference called RAISE 2020. RAISE stands for Responsible AI for Social Responsibility. In fact, this conference was inaugurated by our Honorable Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi ji. And the purpose of this conference is how to cater and then provide the developments to social empowerment. So in the sense that how to make India a perfect garage in the world using AI. AI is going to be the biggest technology revolution. Already, Government of India has trained more than 11,000 youth on basic courses, and currently they are all doing projects. Based on the developments, we can say that AI is recognized as a highly critical growth area with impact across many sectors, including science, government, finance, healthcare, manufacturing, advertising, retail, education, etc. So with this demand in mind, the coordinator of the department, Dr. Salvaraj, has come up with an idea called Machine Learning Algorithms to 5G Networks. So there are, of course, I'm not going into the details about all different types of AI. There are different types of AI. So normally they categorized some AI methods, maybe weak AI belongs to the category of weak AI, and other one is a strong AI. And another way of looking at this is narrow AI versus general AI, then super intelligence, etc. These are all going to play a big role in the coming future. That's why many industries have already started taking candidates with this background, and many institutions have already started PG programs and undergraduate programs in AI and also with specialized areas of data science, etc. But those fundamentals really going to help how to apply these methods into different sectors. So that way, the Department of ECE has identified a very narrow topic, saying that how to use these methodologies or techniques or models, particularly specific to the applications of 5G networks. So this gives a strong understanding, but basic, I think this workshop covers some basic concepts also related to the machine learning and how these machine learning algorithms are going to be applied on the mobile 5G mobile data networks. So this is one of the important topic today. Nowadays, every student has to undergo these methods very critically so that they can get a good job in the industry, because every industry is also looking at the exposure on these topics. So again, I congratulate the entire the Department of ECE, NITM Kanchipuram, for planning this ATAL program under AICT scheme and the 5G application of machine learning algorithms to 5G networks. Of course, already the organizer has mentioned certain rules and regulations of this program. So all of you, please follow the guidelines and instructions given by the coordinator from time to time. I, on behalf of NITM Kanchipuram, I also thank the chief guest from IIT Hyderabad, IIT Hyderabad, for accepting our request to deliver the inaugural address. I wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your stimulating speech, sir. I am profusely elated to take an opportunity to introduce our chief guest of the day, Dr. Sai Dheeraj Amaru, Principal Research Engineer, WiSig Networks, and Adjunct Professor, IIT Hyderabad. Dr. Sai Dheeraj Amaru has obtained his BTech degree in Electrical Engineering from IIT Madras in 2009 and received the MS and PhD from Virginia Tech, USA in 2014 and 2015 respectively. He is a researcher interested in design and analysis of wireless communication systems. Currently, he is Principal Research Engineer with WiSig Networks at IIT Hyderabad, where he is involved with algorithm design and development for 4G and 5G. Also, he is an adjunct assistant professor at IIT Hyderabad, where he teaches courses and leads the physical layer, system design, algorithms design, and research part of the 5G testbed project. He was awarded the Exemplary Reviewer Award for 2019 IEEE Wireless Communication Letters Journal. He also won the Best Paper Award at ComsNet 2020. Previously, he was 3GPP RAN1 Delegate representing Samsung R&D India and involved in 3GPP 5G NR Layer 1 standardization activities. He has made significant contributions to the NR Layer 1 specification in the areas of initial access, random access, frame structure, bandwidth path, and beam management. For this work, which resulted in several standard accepted patents, he was given the IP Creator Award for the year 2017. At Samsung, he has also led research activities related to applications of machine learning for wireless communication problems. In his PhD research, he used tools from statistical signal processing, optimization theory, statistical learning theory, and stochastic geometry to develop optimal attack strategies against wireless networks across physical, MAC, and network layers. Prior to his PhD, he was a modem engineer with Qualcomm, where he worked on radio frequency drivers for its modem chipset. At Qualcomm, he was given several Qualstar awards for excellent performance across various projects and development of RF drivers for a new chipset based on WCDMA. Now I kindly request our chief guest of the day to address the gathering.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for the nice introduction. Good morning, Director sir, and good morning all colleagues. Firstly, congratulations to IIITDM for organizing such a wonderful event. I wish all the very best for a wonderful week and to have thought-provoking sessions on this very timely 5G and machine learning topics and their interconnection. So as Director sir has pointed out, I mean, both of these areas are the hot areas, not just in India, everywhere, all across the world. And as faculty, I think we must be up to date on this hot topic so that when students come to us, we will be ready to give them research topics. So as you all know, 5G is kicking. It's already catching up steam in India. Trials are already happening in India, and within maybe a year and a half, we'll mostly see some 5G deployments in India as well. Some of you, I'm not sure how many of you are aware of it, but from India side, we also have a 5G standard. So there is a 5G standard from an organization called 3GPP, which is what most of the industries are propagating for. But from India side, IIT Hyderabad, IIT Madras, and an organization, CIVET, we have been pushing for India's own 5G standard, which has got a global approval from an UN organization called ITU, which stamped it as an IMT 2020 standard. So 5G is something not new in India. We have been working on it from almost 6 to 7 years. Making a 5G standard is not an overnight success story, but it takes several years of effort of several dedicated researchers to make it a success. So now 5G is already happening. 5G, it's already been defined, but it is now time to prove it that it will work. So it actually started in 2011 by my colleagues from Samsung who I have worked with very closely when I was with Samsung. 2011 was when the research started. 2015, 2016 timeframe was when the standard started getting defined. Now we are working to prove that 5G is actually working. Of course, the big companies have already done it. We are also, I am part of a startup called WiSig Networks inside IIT Hyderabad, where we are also developing 5G products. So designing a modem teaches you wireless communications more than reading books. That is a phase I am in right now, and I think we all should do that. If you have not implemented anything, you won't learn. Now, coming to machine learning, so 5G, once you have defined it, the next hot topic people are talking about is 6G. One realization that we had in India, not just in academia, but also in government circles, is that 2G, we have done it 15 years later than the rest of the world. 3G, we did it 10 years later than the rest of the world. 4G, we did it 7 years later than the rest of the world. 5G, yeah, still we are lagging. Maybe it's 3, 4, 5 years later than the rest of the world. For 6G, we don't want to do that. We want to cut it short. There are several committees that the government has started. There are independent committees that are led by industrial consortiums. We have already started discussing 6G. India will be a power force in defining 6G, and we need all your support, all the intelligent minds across the world, to define 6G, make India a powerful force in this direction. And of course, machine learning is one of the topics that is being discussed for 6G. I hope I and some other colleagues who will be imparting knowledge this week will help you and understand what are the directions that you may take. You may carry out some research in this direction, start contributing into government organizations, government committees, and help. I mean, eventually, we all should strive to make India a power force in not just any other domain, every domain. I mean, nuclear, atomic, we are all leading. India has made a name. But now in technology, telecom, 5G, 6G, we should also make a name. India should become a workhorse. And I request all your support for this. And lastly, I'll just end with good luck and have a great week ahead.
Thank you very much, sir, for sharing your thoughts and experience with us. We are pleased to have your presence in this FTC. I request Dr. M.D. Selvaraj sir to propose the vote of thanks.
So it is my privilege to propose a word of thanks and acknowledge the contribution of those who worked hard to make this FTP possible. On behalf of the entire fraternity of the Tripletidium, first of all, I would like to express my gratitude and sincere thanks to the Atal AICT Academy for giving us this opportunity and sponsoring us to conduct this 5-day FTP. I would like to express my sincere thanks to our Honorable Director, sir, for gracing this occasion, and also for his steadfast cooperation in all the activities. I would like to give a very really heartfelt word of thanks to our chief guest, who has immense knowledge in 5D. I'm very, very happy about Dr. Sai Tiraj, and I just gone through his profile. It is very excellent profile, and he has excellent work experience in 5D. So I'm sure that the Tripletidium going to get benefit of Dr. Sai Tiraj collaborations, who spent his busiest time gracing this occasion, and also for giving the first talk for the day. Today we had the opportunity to hear your thoughts, and this is definitely encouraging us in our future events. I would like to thank the head of the department, Dr. Priyanka Kokil, for introducing our department to the participants and also be supportive in all our activities. So I would like to take this opportunity to express my sincere thanks to our honorable speakers. All of them have been working with us since the beginning of the planning stage, and they are still here today for all of us, even though they are very busy with their responsibilities, schedules, etc. I may like to express my sincere thanks to my faculty colleagues, staff, and research scholars. Finally, I would like to thank all the participants from all over India who have registered for this FTP. A special mention to the registrar and the CRICSEL for their overall administrative support. Finally, this is an opportune time for me to declare the official opening of the 5-day faculty development program on machine learning algorithms for 5G mobile networks, and I wish all 5 fruitful days of interesting and beneficial program. I thank you one and all again. So participants, if you find any difficulties in joining or any sessions, so you please, you can call to my mobile number. My mobile number is already I shared with you, and thank you one and all.
Thank you all. Good luck. Thank you, the Sai Dheeraj, for accepting our request to deliver a talk. Thank you.
Absolutely happy, sir. I mean, I had a pleasure working with several Tripletidium students as part of our 5G testbed program. I'm looking forward to work with more people. I mean, very brilliant minds, I should say.
Right. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Dr. Sai.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
All the best. Yeah. Thank you.